विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांता स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। सो वी आर गोइंग थ्रू दिस ब्यूटिफुल सेगमेंट एंड चैप्टर 4 वेयर कृष्णा इज डिस्क्राइबिंग the wonderful characteristics of devotees who perform devotion. So here in 22nd shloka, Krishna continues to describe to Arjuna, yadrachcha labha santushto dvandva tito vimatsarah samasiddhau asiddhau cha kritva pina nibadhyate. So what is yet another trait of Krishna's devotees? Yadrachcha labha santushto. He is satisfied with whatever gain comes on its own accord. He will not over-endeavor for it. He is simply interested in performing the action. Whether labha comes, whether nashta comes, gain, loss, he is not worried about it. Yadrucha, as it is, by the providence of will, whatever comes, he is okay with that. So there was this one sannyasi. And sannyasi, you know, it is their duty to beg from door to door, go home to home and beg with a begging bowl. While the sannyasi was doing it, again, they don't do this necessarily to keep their own body and soul together. It is not simply to feed their stomach. But actually, for the sannyasis, this is a wonderful opportunity to preach to the householders about Krishna consciousness. Because householders have so many things, they're busy. So sannyasi takes this opportunity when he comes and says, Bhavati Bhikshan Dehi. So that time when the grihastha comes out to give something in charity, that time the sannyasi will speak a few words of wisdom. So he came to this one household, and once he called out, Bhavati Bhikshan Dehi, and nobody responded. He called the second time, third time, and he was sure that there was this, you know, the householder Grihini. The lady is there at home, but still she is doing so many other things, but she is ignoring this man, the sannyasi. But he repeatedly is calling out again and again and keeping him waiting for maybe an hour or two. And then later this lady is not able to tolerate this. She is simply not going away. So the lady comes and she is, you know, with so much of anguish, she says, how come you are, you know, not leaving? Don't you know that I have been trying to ignore you? Can't you just go to the next home? And to see also you are quite fit and fine. Why don't you go and work somewhere? Why have you come here? And then this man, he doesn't lose his composure and all that. The sannyasi, he just stays very composed. And he says, Mother, please give something in charity. And then she is like, you know, even more anguished that still even after chastising him is not going. And back and forth like this conversation is happening, and then she simply can't stand him. So she just barges inside the home and she goes to the jula, the stove where they use the wooden logs. So she just grabs some ash with her two hands and she rushes out and she puts that ash into his bowl and says, here, take it, go. And this man has this big smile on his face and this lady is like, you're still not angry, you're still smiling. What are you smiling about? I gave you a bunch of ash, don't you see? He said, Mother, at least today you have started the act of giving. Never mind that you gave me ash. Today you have given ash, tomorrow you may give cash, who knows. But at least you started the act of giving, and that itself is noble. Somewhere the process has begun. So my point here is, yadrucha labha santushto, a devotee, whether ash comes, cash comes, whether nothing comes, he doesn't worry. He's not like, oh, I worked so hard, how come, you know, I didn't get merit raise, oh, how come I didn't get promotion, or he's not jumping up and down thinking, I got a double promotion, I got so much money. Either way, gain comes, loss comes, doesn't matter. Yadrucha labha santushto, santushtaha, always content with whatever comes or whatever doesn't come. And then dvandva tito. Anything in this material world is, it's a world of duality. There's birth, there's death. There is happiness, there is sorrow. There is loss, there is gain. There is day, there is night. But in the spiritual world, there is no duality. That's why it's called absolute world. And Krishna is telling, my devotees, dvandva tito, they have gone beyond these dualities. Because they are situated on the platform of transcendence, spirituality. So like this, there are few more qualities that Krishna is going to describe in this particular sloka. So let's come back and discuss that in the next video. Until then, you keep relishing these qualities and aspire to imbibe these qualities. Until then, take care. Hare Krishna.